Hello, ladies. This is Margaret Salee. I'm coming to you guys to tell you this afternoon how I did this finish on my altered clock. I had several people ask me, so I'm going to show you guys. This is the clock I altered, and I did the finish that was on it. I'm going to set my camera down, so I don't know if you guys can see that. That's what the finish looks like. So this clock I found at the thrift store, so let me set my camera down. I'm not trying to make you guys sick. This clock I found at the, we got you guys in frame here, just making sure here. Okay, so this clock I found at the thrift store, and it was just this silver color. Okay, I'm going to show you off my little cans here of how I did it. So the clock was just silver, and we took the back off the clock, and we took all the guts out of the clock, and we stripped it, and I took it all, it was in pieces. And this part comes off, the little legs come off, the glass comes out of it. I even hot glued this little clabber thing, I hot glued it inside because it was part of the face of the clock. So, what I used to make it the way it looks here was I took the white gesso and I coated the clock with white gesso all over it. Inside, outside, the back, everything. Once you get your can or your clock coated with gesso, so it looks like that, then I took to get these colors, this kind of vintage distressed look. Tracy had these in her store for the Tim Holtz tags, and I bought them. I'd never had them before, and I thought, well, I'll try them and see if they work. So she had the ice spruce and the green bough in her store, and that was for, I think it was last month's tag. And then I had this one. I've gotten it somewhere on sale someplace. And it's the weathered wood one, and this is a little different. It's a lot more liquidy. It's more of a dye and not a paint. And then Rosemary got this glimmer dust for me and sent it to me, and this stuff is awesome. And then I used Inca Gold, and I'll show you guys how I did that. So if you guys aren't familiar with these, which I had never used them before, I'd seen Tim Holtz do them, they kind of have a cotton sponge on them. Mr. P's going to get his 2 cents in here. So you got to kind of push down on something to get the sponge to activate. And then what I did is I just did a line, and then I took my fingers and I kind of ran it along the edge of the clock. Now, this can has like rims, so it's not going to be the same as it would be on the clock where the, like, see the smooth area there? Where you can really smooth it and blend it, okay? But you'll get the ideal from what I'm doing. I don't put it all over. I just do it in little places around the clock, okay? So I've already painted it white, and you can see the gesso doesn't cover it all the way. It kind of makes it silverish. And then I just took and went through with the color and did some random areas of color all over. Okay, and then once you've got that, this stuff doesn't take very long to dry. I'm impatient. Like I told Rosemary, that's one of my big faults. I hate to watch glue dry or paint dry. I've got to have something to do, so I don't wait for anything. So once you activate it, you just rub it on and do it, and you can squeeze the bottle just a little bit, and it helps push it. I don't squeeze it too much. I just rub what I've got on it. I really am kind of liking these Tim Holtz dauber things. But this is all I did. So on my clock, that's what gave me that kind of weathered paint look, is the best way I can describe it. And so I did that. You can see it's just kind of all over. Now this is a little more runnier because this is more of a dye. And so I found you don't want to activate it. It has the same kind of spongy thing, But you'll see here when I put it on, it's really runny. So I just did a little bit, and I just kind of blended it with my finger. I use my fingers a lot, guys. I'm sorry if you guys don't. I don't know how else to tell you, maybe a blending brush. I kind of say that if your hands have paint on them, it's a, like a badge of courage. And I wear it with honor. I love showing people that I've done things. And so you can see the difference. There's the lighter gray. There's what I'm just putting on. There's the green and, of course, the gesso. Now, you don't want to, like, fill it all the way in because that takes some of that character away from it that you're going to get from it. See how it – oops, see what I did? So that's what I said. It's a little more runnier than the other. So I, but just rub it in. There is never a mistake in crafting. It's the way it's supposed to be. That's how I always look at it. Everybody's like, oh, I messed it up. I'm like, nah, you didn't mess it up. Just go from there. So, and just keep rubbing till you get it the way you want it, and it looks like the weathered barn or however you want it to look. I kind of, years ago, they used to use that green a lot in their appliances, and my mom always had the avocado green in our house because she loves avocado green. But I remember this blue green from when I was a child. Yeah, I'm that old. So after you let it set and dry, and I took, and once again, I'm kind of, I don't ever, I do use paintbrushes, you guys, but I just took my finger and dabbed it out because I'm going to do the same thing I did with the paint. I just want a little bit of gloss on it. I don't want it really, really super glossy. And I'm the glitter queen here. I love glitter. But this stuff that Rosemary sent me, it looks like it's not very shiny. But oh my goodness, you guys, when this stuff dries, it's fabulous. So if you can get this, it's Glamour Dust. Get this. She said she gets it at Hobby Lobby, and I haven't gone in search of it. At our Hobby Lobby, I call it kind of a misfit Hobby Lobby. It just doesn't have everything you guys say you get. So we're going to let that dry for just a second or two. Like I told you, I'm impatient. And, of course, we're on video, so I'm not going to let it dry all the way. This Inca Gold is a rub, and I got it on clearance at Hobby Lobby. And when you look at it, it's kind of thick. It's a, I want to say it's like shortening, but it's a different kind of texture, almost like your clay. And so I take it, and I get a little bit on my finger, and then I just go randomly. I don't, and just put enough to catch the highlights. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. But you're just bringing it, just a little gloss in there. You're not, like, painting it all over. And I did this all over the clock. You can kind of see it along the edges and that. Sometimes I'll even take this Inca Gold stuff and put it on the edges of some of the flowers if I want some gold on them, because it's, with it being kind of a paste, it like sticks to everything. And of course, you'd probably let it dry a little bit more in between than I'm doing so that your colors lay down a little better, but sometimes I'm this impatient. I just keep right on going. I want to see it now. I love crafting, and it's like when it starts to come together, it starts to come together. So as you look, see, it's still a little bit wet, but as you look, you can see the different definitions of the rustic-looking paint. And that's how I did my finish on my clock. So once you get your clock gutted out, paint it white, and have at it. Now, if you don't have these daubers from Tim Holtz, Tracy does have them in her store, or if she doesn't have them in the store, if you click on them and they say they're not available, contact Tracy and she can get them for you. But if you don't have them, you can do the same thing with acrylic paint, you guys. Just put a little on your finger and just rub it on there. Don't be afraid to do it. So as you see on my clock, which I'm hoping I'm not getting it too close to you guys, that's all I did. I just rubbed it all over. I put a base behind my clock or under my clock. It's just one of those wooden boards because my clock didn't want to stand up. So I wanted it to stand up, and I had it all decorated, and every time I set it down, it would fall over. So that's how I did my finish, ladies. If you have any other questions, please go ahead and PM me. I'm going to post this on to YouTube here really quick. And I'm so excited. I've seen so many different clocks already. You guys are just, it got me tickled pink. You know, everyone is different. So congratulations, ladies, on the clock. And I can't wait until we do our swaps. And have a great day.